Yeah, good afternoon, everybody. This is Dr. Praveen Saxena. I tell you, chairpersons, I'm a medical doctor trying to work on something called the social aspects as well. I'd like to discuss something about why there is so much increase in cardiac diseases. I'm coming to this area for the first time, but I do have a lot of my patients who come all the way from Girimitla to Surah. And in the slides, I'll show you why this particular thing is happening day in and day out. I definitely like to correct everyone. This is a basically, as a clinicians, we are not able to. So I believe that we must always change, and we need to relieve our bottleneck. And there are five doctors which help us incessantly, and we don't have to go to any consultant. I can tell about very briefly sunlight. We used to worship sunlight, Suri Devta. We talk about air, which is Pavan Devta. See, sunlight causing vitamin D, all of you know about that. And this is a paradox. Living so close to the equator, we still have that kind of vitamin D deficiency. I'll just show you why this deficiency is happening and how we can get over that. Air, Pavan Devta, air is somehow, in the last 2 years, everyone started talking in the media, and there was a prime time channel, everyone talked about Delhi air pollution and all that. We'll see how this is affecting our health as such. I'm talking about five things I told you. The third one, I talk about the sleep, which is our recharge, right? Sleep is a recharge. And someday, we are always connected, continually connected with all internet, all things as such. We don't even tend to close the Wi-Fi. And I can always tell you, people, they start boasting as such. Oh, I'm 24/7, I'm connected to Wi-Fi. I think we are slowly heading towards a disaster, and we need to correct ourselves, otherwise it's difficult to get into something. And some few things as such, and we were not able to live. We are talking about all these degenerative diseases. I will try to focus my talk only about the cardiovascular, which is vascular disease. And somehow, what I try to understand is, it is basically, it's a hardening of vessels which is causing. Why this hardening of vessels are happening? As a medical student, I'm talking about way back in 85, I joined medicine in Usman Mali College, and I couldn't answer my dad, who asked me, I don't take a lot of cholesterol, I don't take non-veg, I don't take any tea, I don't know what is red label or white label. Yeah, he was not aware of all that stuff. And why, how come I got into that? So as a medico with the apron on my left shoulder, I was in the cloud nine as well. And I used to say, no, we have that genetics, and with that we get into problems. And I don't think we did convince my father, because my granddad lived up to an age of 87 without any problems. So all things are happening in a big way. Our ancestors, they had a high fat diet. Yeah, they used to, there was no kind of rationing and all that, everything was taken in excess as such. I know these are all the things. This area, recently we had a 31-year-old came with MI, and it's not that we don't take care of MI, but we try to work on the other part as such. After stenting, he was asked to go for some things as such. And we found there was a lead toxicity, and we tried to work on. My focus will be mostly talking on the lead toxicity, and I believe this is a public health importance as well. The way things are going is very, very. I know all of you, sir, everyone in your sphere knows somebody who is very active, he quits smoking, he walks regularly, he does all the stuff, and somehow something happens to this guy, and we need. This is a day-to-day phenomena. Everyone knows a case of cardiac this problem, diabetes and heart disease. Now the cancer is the other thing. Everyone knows there is something, somebody in the family. So what we just wanted to put across is, yeah, there are always things as such, you get into things. But nobody, we were trying to take care of the acute problems very well. You have a have a strength, you try to follow, you have try to work on a thing as such, you have got a large vessels, you have a medium sized vessels, you have a smaller vessels, you have capillaries. So what is happening is, as doctors, we are treating only the large highways. This highway we are just trying to build. We are not trying to cater anyway with the capillaries and all that. And mind you, most of our patients are highly diabetic, and microvascular syndromes are very, very rampant in almost all patients as such. I think I had talking about this particular case as such, but I don't want to go into further because of the paucity of time. What I try to put across is, we all know as medical students, what is the cause of heart disease. Now you talk to a driver, now you talk to anyone as such, he says, oh, sir, oh, cholesterol, that is the kind of thing as such. So somewhere, I am not going to talk about all this usual stuff. I am here to give you a food for thought. Ladies, I am going to ask you a question also. Just try to answer that if you can later after the why MIs do occur only during early mornings in the middle of night. Why corporate hospitals are busy only at that particular time. The second question will go like that is why ladies are not prone for MIs. Of course, now everyone is catching up. They are always equal now, but somehow postmenopausal ladies, premenopausal ladies, they are not prone for heart disease. They don't go into vascular inserts. You need to answer after I complete my thing as such. We'll discuss that particular thing in the tea session as such. I picked up something called environmental factors which are causing directly increasing heart problems, which are air pollution, drinking water hardness, mercury, arsenic and lead. What do you mean to say that? I am born in Hyderabad, sir. 30 years back, what we have seen? There were no boreholes. Now we see everywhere is borewell. And I am really surprised by the way the layout was poor. Somebody staying in, one of my relatives was staying in some place near Nacharam. And he was staying just beside a factory. I don't think any sensible government or some sensible policy makers would do this kind of mistake. Thing is, you cannot have a population among all this kind of stuff. You are going to pay very dearly. I'll be talking about mercury, arsenic and lead. Let me start with this thing as such. I'll be focusing only on the lead. We have a society of lead, society of India, sir. It's called INSLA. We have different people. It's not just medical doctors. There are some scientists. There are some different people out there. And we conducted second lead conference in India. That was in NIM. We did it last year. This was an international conference as such. I just want to say that if this particular kind of incessant heavy metal pollution, something which is directly causing the increase in heart rates, problems as such, and I will talk with arsenic first. Arsenic, it's freely available in India. All this wood walls, there are so many sources of arsenic, and this arsenic, there was a study. It was a retrospective finding. What happened in Taiwan was there was a disease called black foot disease, which erupted. Every person was having in Taiwan, one village, everyone was started having black foot. So what social epidemiologists started looking at that, they were using from a common well. They were taking water from a common well. Everybody was getting black foot disease of Taiwan, it's called. Black foot disease, later it was found, it was a arsenic content which was higher in that particular well, which caused that particular. This is way back in 77, and in the same group as such, there was a prospective study still going on. And what was spent was, the coronaries were taken in all these patients who had got black foot disease. Black foot disease is gangrene of the legs. And you have got a thickened coronaries as such. And Rosenberg has done a study, and still there is an ongoing prospective study which are studying the thickened arteries and all that. And this is an important study which was done by Zerold and all that. They have surveyed some people, about 1,000 and odd, and they started correlating things as such. Increased number of depression, increased number of circulatory problems, increased number of diabetes and all sorts, this kind of stuff. They could relate all these things to the increased content of arsenic in water. You don't think it's happening in Hyderabad? I have the stats to prove as such. We were talking about 30 micrograms of arsenic. Now I take any sample of water. I bet I'll take a sample of water here, it will be more than 60. It looks like more sweet water. The chicken what we are eating, that is also a source of arsenic thing as such. So I'll come back to the lead part, and in fact this was one of the things which were eye-opener for us, and we are able to relate now. Now we are doing with thyrocare all the lead levels in the blood, and we see all hypertensives in Hyderabad around, they have minimum of 20 to 30 micrograms. MCG per liter. There is this kind of thing as such. And I referred this one to my mentors in US. I showed them this report, things as such. And in US, they don't want any lead in the body. The lead levels, what has been described, there was 0 to 5. Now they talk about NOEL, no observable effects of lead. So there cannot be lead in the body. And here we have, I can bet you, Dr. Sanjay, it was an interesting thing here. I am sure we will have high levels of lead here. I checked myself, it is more than 30. It was 30 something like that. The point I am trying to make across is, this lead toxicity is so prevalent. And we used to always tell, no, it's a tension and all that, high tension. Unless you see, this is very thing about oxidative stress. This oxidative stress is caused by this high lead and other stuff, and unless you remove that, you cannot go further. So these are the studies, and now there are a number of studies. I picked up a lot of studies because I just thought I'll show you some things. We were only doing with thyrocare, we started doing with DRDO in mass, and before that I used to do in microtrace minerals in Germany. I worked in something called autism and other subjects. So this evaluation of all these reports, all these minerals and all that has got a big impact on our practice. So now what we believe is people having mild infection or stroke, whatever things and all that, once they come to us and we see the high levels of that lead or something like that, and we try to work on that, reducing this particular heavy metals, and it gives a excellent results as well. All that thickening of arteries and all that, they are getting better as such. I will show you a few of my, even this people, Schwartz has done increased blood lead levels with left reticular hypertrophy. I also do a 2D echo in my, this one, I'm a radiologist, I go along with a cardiologist, and it's a very kind of rampant thing. What we were taught as elder graduates, the LVH was unknown. Only hypertension is causing LVH. But I think all these youngsters should always take up some case studies and all that. They can always work on a cases of LVH, try to localize what exactly is causing that. This is again the left ventricular mass with compared to the ejection fraction. And we tried replicating this kind of work here. And to our surprise, the complex is very low, sir. There is like, we try to Amar Raja battery. I tried to get into that, and we were trying to pick up how many hypertensives and all that. All data was fudged. Nobody wants to acknowledge that if lead from that battery unit is a problem as such. Chinese refinery workers with lead levels of mostly more than 50 micrograms, and they have on the IVS as well as LVH, and this is it's not a big this one when we are talking about all this stuff, heavy metals and heavy metals. How does the heavy metal, I'll just give you a brief overview, what exactly happens when we are intoxicated with that particular stuff. This scan, we have discussed about that, increases in vascular tone and all that. Few words about mercury, I'll come back to how the body tries to take care of the toxicity, because you may be having a good mechanism, the other person may not be having a good mechanism. It all depends on your individual D detoxing skills. Okay, the mercury was one thing, it was always a problem thing. As said, we it, now I don't think we can, in our clinics we are not keeping the mercury thermometer, but I'm sure most of you people still may be carrying that particular stuff. And I tell you, a mercury thermometer, if it drops here, and it is going to, all of your medical college is going to be toxic mercury, I can always assure you. One thermometer mercury in a Hussein Sagar can kill all the fishes, that's what the saying has said. We don't have now, all the fishes are killed, are not there in Hussein Sagar. So what happened was, this work which was done in 2002 by European and Israeli men, they started looking at the nails and hair content of the mercury. Almost all people who had a MRI or posted, they had high levels of mercury in that cell. This is mercury sources, I will not go much into that, but you need to be careful. When my mentor, when he sees me in Seattle and all that, he comes talking to me, look into the teeth and all that, I didn't understand what he was talking. And now we see any patient, the first thing we look into the mouth, you have got some dental amalgams and things and all that, all these are lead and mercury, which is dead. And there's no big rocket science that you are going to get into problems. So lack of selenium, cadmium is one thing which is causing a big issue. I thought this data will, anyone can always pick, you can send me a mail and send you all this data with you. Air pollution is one thing. We started doing something called PM2.5 and PM10. 3 years back we started working in Hyderabad. We went to the schools of that, Christopher is here, and we started collecting some data. To our surprise, this is very fluctuant. PM2.5 and PM10, the measures, we have a unit asset with which we measure that, and we try to do it in the school, and during the children entering inside, and during the class session, as well as after in the interval period, when they start playing and all that. So what we could see is, all this period, when the child is playing and when the school is there, the thing as such, the high levels of that and it goes down. So I think all of us have to take this particular air exposure and cardiovascular morbidity very, very seriously. And there are reports, there was a Harvard 6 study was done where they show people living on the main roads, right, they are having high levels of problems, they are getting into some issues and all that. So I think we need to take this very, very seriously. And similarly, there were a lot of other studies also, and this carbon monoxide and all that, you know. We had some cases where a patient is having an angina and the pulmonary arteries are normal. How do you explain that? You have any idea what I am talking about? It is not just it's a question of block. It's not the question of block. It's a question of what the content of carbon monoxide in the thing also can cause your angina death. Even if you have a normal coronary also. I'll take up other things, but this, there is an abundant study, and it is now, we have telling about last 15 years, we are talking about this particular stuff, and thanks to, I should not say thanks, because of the Delhi airport pollution, everything has come into light, and people are really asking questions which are not comfortable to doctors. We need to look at this kind of thing. Drinking water, I believe it's a bigger issue here, and I somewhere believe that whatever what we have with RO filters and all stuff and all that. And I made a point when we were children 30 years back, it's not that I'm 50 plus now. So, but what happened was there was an abundant increase in the groundwater. We used to have only circular water. We used to go 10 feet deep and used to get water which was good in minerals as such. Now we don't find that kind of minerals. We go to 1000 feet and all of this thing is a trap. You don't get a good magnesium and good calcium and all that. For beginners, I can always tell you why this man is talking so much against the heavy metals and all that. I will definitely tell you, refer back to your periodic table. If you can refer back to your periodic table, you know there are minerals, there are something called calcium, magnesium, there is something called selenium, there is something called zinc, which are good minerals. we, while going for the SPM posting, we used to rectify that what is the level of zinc, what are the things and all that, what are the antigens and all that. I don't think nobody is getting zinc properly now, because the whole of the thing, the land, fields, everything is devoid of magnesium, zinc. We don't have any good calcium either, sir. So what happened, why is this, there is so much displacement? It is because of these heavy metals, they come and displace that particular stuff. It's very, very simple. You try, you look at the thing for electron transport chain in the mitochondria. Okay, it is all, magnesium is required in more than 300 enzymatic reactions. Correct me if I'm wrong, more than, it must be more than that. And where all the places magnesium need to be there, when your bigger don, lead or mercury sits over there, all this enzymatic reactions goes for excretion body, and then that is the starting of the disease. So water is the, I think we are talking about so much about mineral water, we are talking about that plastics and all that. We have to take a, we need to review water. I'm really happy you are using that bottled water, that's good man. Industrial chemicals, coming to a place called, I'm coming here for the first time. I never knew what was getting better, but I can always tell you, staying here, taking water here is going to be risky. So coming back to what is endosclerosis, and you, all of you are aware of these things, and we talk about endothelial dysfunction in injury, fatty streaks. We are getting at a 10 years old also having that fatty streaks and all that, and how this plaque rupture and what happens and all that. Do not go deep into all this stuff. I'd like to tell you an important line of thing as such, which we designing the other cardiology. We don't see artery as just pipe. It's basically a live thing as such. It has got 98 enzymatic systems there out there, and there's a big things which happen there, which is something to do with the prostaglandins and thromboxane. If you have attended your biochemistry properly, thromboxanes are the worst things, prostaglandins are the good things. What is happening with our diet, maybe it's happening with our things as well. Our thromboxane activity is going up. And yes, once you start getting a plaque, you start getting the diffuse kind of stuff, there is not proper diffusion things happens across. And we know about all these things, nitric oxide and all that, there is a dysfunction. This is what I was trying to tell about, that even if you are having a arterial angiography which is normal, still you can have a nitric oxide, an endothelial dysfunction can be there. This causes the problem. And this endothelial dysfunction is happening because of all these heavy metals and chemicals and all that. And we try to remove this particular things by doing something called chelation therapy. And before that, we try to show that the heavy metals are there. And we are not doing this for a cardiac problem. We tell that we are reducing your heavy metal toxicity. The moment your heavy metal toxicities are reduced, we have patients who are smiling back and they are walking again three floors. And I liked that particular caption when I came here. I took a photograph also, that walking up the stairs is a good thing. But I don't think everyone is able to do that because of the knee joint as well as some cardiac kind of stuff. But we can all do it. We have patients, sir. We have patients who are not able to walk for 6 steps or 8 steps after doing this kind of chelation. They are going for 4 floors also. I'll not bore you with some of this particular stuff. Any things which you feel I have gone over more, because I start, right? I'm not keeping it. How much time we have left? Other 10 minutes? 10 minutes? Okay. I'll try to give you a small overview. What exactly is chelation? Chelation is something like trying to heavy metal. I told you there are some heavy metals which come in place of magnesium, calcium and all that. They get stuck there. We need to remove that. So there is a thing called synthetic amino acid, which is called ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. We try to use this particular thing and try to remove that particular. And I was talking about this kind of. We see two brothers and one brother is having very healthy, other brother having a problem. They have the same genes and what happened. Why this people are reoriented? So now we believe that it is the dysfunctional elimination systems. It's a dysfunctional, your kidneys are not properly excreting, your skin is not excreting. Now I don't see people sweating out. Sweating is a good mechanism, right? So similarly, your hepatobiliary system doesn't work. Your bile doesn't contract, your gallbladder doesn't contract. It's the kind of modern kind of stuff what we are having as. So these are all the things which are making you ill. So with this relation, we are trying to see that things are getting better again. We are trying to work on that thing. We try to work on a particularly heart patients. We do something called non-surgical bypass, wherein we try to display every approved procedure, and where we are trying to work on a simple technique where we are improving the diastolic perfusion in the arteries. I just think if so we try to make the kind of collaterals which the normally they develop as well. What is happening is the concept of ECP is enhanced external contour perfusion, where the patient is made lie down and there is a compression over the calves, thighs as well as the pelvis, and we do the coronary flow during the diastole. Right? Any of the people in physiology, if somebody is from physiology, they can always they can always give me a run for money as well, because I work on some kind of things. This is a thing of physiology. You improve the circulation, you improve the perfusion in the coronaries during the diastole. It causes release of vaso-endothelial growth factors and endothelial dysfunction will be gone, and you start developing collaterals. You don't require an artificial bypass surgery to get a collateral as such. There is a small video here. If I try to show, okay, fine. I'm not able to show it that. This is the experimental dog's heart, where on the left side you see the normal coronaries which have got blocks, functional blocks, and after this ECP, which is the newer version, we are able to see the increased collaterals as such. We did a study, and the study was basically dealing with that, doing the detoxification, like to work with the ECPs and all that, and all the what we had 20 cases, and we had almost all of them, most of them, they went through a major bypass or a stent, and they had post MI people as such. We started the therapy, and we were able to compare with some of the parameters. We were banged on first was stress thallium, and we were trying to work with that. TMT was slightly inaccurate kind of stuff as such, so we didn't rely much on that, and the outcome was totally excellent and all that. But we were always trying to follow up the patient who had, he takes one stair of taste and he gets sent in. We were following that particular stuff. And people who are having dyspnea, and we were trying to look at the other things also. There were other parameters which we felt this was important. Because somewhere we, there is some big thing as said. I can always share you what I try to work it out. Almost all cardiac cases with diabetes and all that, we do see there is a thing for fatty liver. And this fatty liver, unless we remove the fatty liver, we try to work on that, things are not going to work. Whatever you give statins, whatever you give his triglyceride, everything keeps on coming as such. So we need to, as a treat as a holistic kind of thing, it's not just for the cardiac or vessels you treat, you have to treat that as a whole as such. Now we were able to present this data into one of the things as such, and we have the patient's kind of thing also. And subsequently, what data we did was a very smaller one. There was a thing called THP trial which happened. This was phase 3 trial. This 2 is ongoing now, and where they were looking at the efficacy of this therapy, whether you can give it for cardiac patients or not. As a matter of fact, I am qualified as a clinical mental toxicologist.